Hi folks, CodeTutor here, and my name is Anil Deshpande.
Welcome to the next video in Room Database implementation series. Let's have a quick recap of what we have implemented in the previous video. We implemented two functionalities in the country repository, that is fetch and insert all and get all countries. And then we implemented the view model. We implemented fetch and insert view all, which delegated it to the country repository, and then implemented get all countries in the country view model and initialized the all countries and ease loading. These two are being used by the composable. The composable is main screen, and in the composable, you basically initialized DAO and then the country repository and then finally the country view model. And to initialize the country view model, we also created a view model provider factory. And when we ran this particular application, I am only seeing one card. And we then went to the inspection, went to the application, and we realized that there is only one country in the database. So that's the story so far. Now we will try to fix this issue. Even before we fix the issue, let's go to the repository and see how many countries are we actually getting. So let me debug the application and let me run the application in the debug mode. I am getting 250 countries from the API, but the insert all is not working fine. What could be the issue? Well, the problem is if you go to the country, the primary key ID int is initialized to zero. So what basically happens is when we are continuously inserting multiple countries in the database, everything is zero. And by default, if it gets a conflict, it will basically replace. And that is a problem. How do I know that? If you just go to the country DAO, in case of insert on conflict, the conflict strategy is replace. So it is basically replacing the one it has inserted with another new one. So even though there are 250, each one is getting replaced with the new one, and we are only ending up with one entry at the end in the database. So how do we fix that then? Instead of making it zero, let me make it null and then uninstall this and let me rerun the application. Now, hopefully this issue is resolved. So that was the problem. So we have solved the issue. And if you just go here once again to the inspection and go to the database, now you will see that it has quite a lot of entries in the database. And you can actually write a query here. You can say select star from country and run this, and you should be able to get. And you can say where CCA3 like ZAF. I am basically giving this option and run. And now we only got one tuple as the return. So yeah, this works. Now it is time to implement the delete feature. What we want to basically do is we want to click on one of these cards, maybe a long click. And when I do that, a pop-up should appear asking, do you want to delete this particular country? And if I say yes, that country should get deleted. So let's try to implement that particular feature. The first thing is we have to go to the repository. So let's add another suspend function, delete country, and maybe we need to pass the country. And once again, it is with context dispatches.io. And here I am going to use the country DAO dot delete country, pass the country. And after that, all countries need to be refreshed. That is all countries is equal to country DAO dot get all countries. And this will ensure that after deleting, our list is refreshed. Now let's open the view model. This delete function will be called from the composable. So this cannot be a private suspend function. So let me write a suspend function first, delete country. Inside this, we should delete a selected country. So from the UI, when you do a long click, that country should get selected. So that basically means we need to maintain one mutable state here, which is a selected country for deletion. So initially it will be mutable state of null, and we'll use this in the delete function, that is selected country for deletion. Check the value is not null, and if it is not null, country repository dot delete country, we can pass it. And after that, we have to do get all countries to refresh. And then selected country for deletion should be initialized to null, that is dot value null. So the view model is ready. Now we will have to implement popup alert dialog box. We have already done it before. So to save my time, I will quickly show you the one that I have already implemented. So this is my alert dialog box. It basically takes a state show dialog, which can be true or false. Then you have title, the title of the alert dialog box, the message, and then positive action. This is a callback method, lambda, and that is called when button is clicked. And then show dialog is set to false to basically close the dialog window. We have two buttons. One is confirm and another one is dismiss. And on dismiss also, the show dialog is set to false. Once again, it is better to maintain this show dialog status in the view model. So let me go back to the country view model here and create a variable here, val show delete alert dialog mutable state boolean mutable state of false. Now if I go to main screen, now let me maintain that value here, val show delete alert dialog is equal to view model dot show delete alert dialog dot value, and then I will have to implement this alert dialog here. So my alert dialog show delete alert dialog, title delete confirmation, message do you want to delete this country. There is a problem here. I think this cannot be value. And then inside that I'm using view model dot view model scope dot launch. This is the positive action that we are writing, view model dot delete country, and then that will basically delete and then set the selected country for null. So that is already taken care. Let me just check how this looks. For that, let me make show alert dialog value equals to true and see what happens. Yeah, we are seeing the popup delete confirmation. Do you want to delete this country? So it is working as intended, but this is not how it should automatically pop up. It should pop up based on long click. So that basically means the country card should be designed to handle this. So this country card should not only just take the parameter of the country. It should do a little bit more than that. One is it should take the mutable state of show delete alert dialog box, and then it should take the view model as well, because it is using the view model we will be able to set the selected country for deletion. So let me go back here and pass those things, show delete alert dialog, that is this part, and then view model is equal to view model. So all these are basically passed to the country card. Now let me go to the country card. We can pass these to the country card with constraint layout as well. So I am just updating the signature of this as well. And then I will basically pass show alert dialog and view model. Let me go to the country card with constraint layout. Now it is time to apply the logic to handle the long precedent. So what we can do is for this constraint layout, you can write dot pointer input is the input parameter as unit, and then inside that detect tap gestures, and inside that on long press, handle on long press, we can write log.i. Let me just see whether long press is being recognized or not. So country card long press detected. Let me run the code. Click for long here. Yeah, it is getting recognized. So that's very good. Now let me complete the remaining part of the code. So here on click of long, we should show the dialog box. So that is a show alert dialog box dot value is equal to true. And then view model dot selected country for deletion dot value should be set to that country that we are receiving here. And then if you go back to the alert dialog, one of the parameter it takes is the lambda function, that is positive action. And the way we have implemented that positive action is it should delete the country. And ViewModel.deleteCountry will basically use the selected country for deletion that we have set here in the onDetection of long press. Let me run this code and long press confirm. Yes, it got deleted. Now let me go to the inspection again. I can say initially it were 250 countries, and now I can write count. How many countries are there? If I run this, one less. That's exactly what we want. Now let me do another time. Confirm. Something is not right. It should have got deleted. Let me run this thing again. Yeah, the deletion is not taking place. Something is wrong. So let me stop here. In the next video, we will try to fix why this is not getting deleted properly and then implement the last one functionality, which is update country. So let's do that in the next video.
That brings us to the end of this particular video. Don't forget to like, comment, share the video and subscribe to the channel. Take care. Bye.